Let's talk about cybersecurity. That's a really hot topic now. Can you deep dive into that a little bit for me and talk about how we approach security when it comes to your business?
So, you know, when I mention security to clients, you know, the first thing that comes to mind, if I say, you know, you need to have a good security plan in place, I can watch people and the whole thing is, oh my goodness, this is going to cost me a lot of money. Security doesn't need to be that scary. It really isn't that big of a deal if we can just break it down into the categories and address it from a simpler format. So let's take a look at what I'm talking about. When we look at security, we look at four main categories. We look at perimeter, we look at endpoint, we look at access, and we look at enforceable policy. So let's just deep dive into each one for just a little bit. So let's go with access. Access is this notion that I'm going to give you, the user, access to the files that you need to have access to in order to do your job. But I'm not going to give you access to everything else. So if you're in accounting, you're going to have accounting functions, but you may not have sales data. If you're in marketing material or anything like that. If you're in sales, you may not have access to the accounting information and so on. Then that access needs to be also obviously password protected with a good password security policy that you put in place. So what I'm talking about a password policy is this. If you are in our level 3 of security, and let's go through those real quick. Level 1 is if I have very little intellectual property and I have very little compliance that I need to worry about. For instance, I don't have credit cards, I don't have people's social security numbers, or I don't have any healthcare information, then maybe level 1 security is okay. A level 2 is I have some intellectual property that I want to kind of protect a little bit, but I'm not really worried about anything else. I don't have any of the other things. I don't have to worry about PCI compliance or HIPAA compliance. Level 3 is I have PCI compliance, HIPAA compliance, any of those kinds of things, or intellectual property that if it were to be released somewhere or someone were to get access to it, it would really cause me a great harm or liability. And level 4 is a Department of Defense type of security, where it'd be a multiple factor authentication. If you move away from your PC, it shuts off automatically or locks automatically. You have perimeter security that's physical, meaning that you couldn't get into the server room without multiple access capabilities and so on. So let's think about passwords again for just a little bit. If we are a level 3, then we're suggesting that you have a complex password. That means it's at least 8 characters or greater, with letters, numbers, and spaces and symbols that are involved with it, that changes every 90 days, and that needs to be enforceable. So in other words, it's not just a piece of paper that's got a policy that you hand out to everybody to tell them that they're going to have to change the password every 90 days. It is that the system, the servers, require and make the user change their passwords every 90 days. Now, that can be daunting if you tell a user they got to replace their password every 90 days, yeah. And you got to remember it. So we
can. And it can't be any of the last 3 passwords you had.
Exactly. So it's got to change all the time. So we give some really good tools to help people do that. So my favorite is write down phrases and know a pattern with that phrase, so that you know that, hey, every word, you know, so it's the first word, it's the first letter and it's capitalized. The second word, it's the third letter and it's not capitalized, and so on. But so memorize the pattern and don't necessarily remember the phrase. You can leave that lay anywhere you want to. Nobody's going to understand what that is anyway.
Basically make your own algorithm.
You got it. Exactly. So it's an easier way to understand it. So that's what we're talking about, enforceable policy. Okay. When I talk about endpoint, that is just the notion that all of your workstations, anything that accesses the information, has good antivirus, anti-malware, doesn't have administrative access to the unit itself. So it just means that the user won't be able to install software. Now, the bad part is that the user won't be able to install software, but the good thing is that software, you know, some malware software, some other software that is malicious software, won't be able to be installed on it as well. The other one is perimeter, and let's just take a perimeter for instance. You know, this is firewalls, router switches types of things, and making sure that there are no open ports to the outside. And if there is a port that, you know, if you want to get to the outside, for instance, or you need access from the outside into systems, that there's a VPN in place instead. all a VPN is it's a virtual private network, which just means that we put a little shield around a port that you can go into and get your data and back and forth, and nobody on the internet can see that. That's the idea with that. Let's think about wireless for a little bit. Wireless is one of those really big areas where, you know, we can go in and it seems like there's open access to wireless sometimes, or it's an easy password that can be hacked if you want to. What we're suggesting is this, is that you take all of your wireless access and you split it into two. You have your private side and you have your public side. On the private side, you only put things that are controllable. You know, the PCs that you have anti-malware on, the piece, you know, anything that you can control. On the public side, we suggest that you put everything else, including employees' phones, people that come in from the outside that need access of some kind, put them on the public side and allow the access to that, on that side. If you want, you can still put a password on that. You don't need to have it completely wide open. But it just separates. It separates the two from each other. The idea is contain everything you control and push everything else outside that could cause you harm. Get it away from yourself. It's kind of like a demilitarized zone, kind of separate the two out. So if you can see, there's really, you know, again, back to the four main categories. If you just look at those four main categories, we can look at that, measure against that, and come back to you with a gap report that says, hey, if you really want to be at a level 3 or a level 2 security, this is what we have to do in order to get there. It's not as difficult and as daunting of a task as what it might sound like when you think about security.